What's up? This is Marcus with Machine City Audio. So, that instrumental that you heard at the beginning of the video is actually the instrumental that I made using the DX7 from Arturia's V7 collection, and I used Hyperion strings from Sound Iron. Both great companies that make really great virtual instruments. All right, now I just want to address something right quick about the price of the upgrade to V7 and, you know, just the overall price of the V7 collection. Yes, it is pricey, but look at it as an investment. You know, it's an investment in your craft. If you're making beats, you know, production, whatever, this is an investment. And just look at it like this: if you try to buy any of the hardware versions of these, you're going to pay way more for just one synthesizer if you're able to find it in good condition and use it. You're getting thousands of presets, over 25 instruments that are going to last you a very long time. And I use Arturia in about 90% of my sounds that I use for making beats. Now, Arturia is not paying me. I'm not getting any kind of special treatment from these guys for doing these videos. I'm just doing it because I really think it's great software and I like sharing it with you guys. All right, so that's all I want to touch on that. So let's get into this. All right, so what I wanted to do is challenge myself to see if I can make an instrumental using just one of the virtual instruments from the V7 collection, and I was able to do it. And I happened to use the DX7, which is a really great virtual instrument. I love this one. All right, so real quick, I want to talk about just some of the effects that I'm using on pretty much the whole instrumental. All right, so one of the things I'm using is Lo-Hi from Good Hertz, and this is a really great filtering plugin. Like I said, reminiscent of MPC filtering. So I really like having this, and they make some great plugins. I'll leave a link below if you want to check those guys out. And I also did a video on this reviewing some other plugins. All right, and the next one I want to talk about is Movement. And this one is from Output. This is a really, really great plugin. I love this. It's really great for adding ambience and textures to your instrumentals, you know. So if you're a Presonus user and you have like Studio One, then you were able to get this for free, so hopefully you got it. Definitely great. I will leave a link to this as well if you want to check it out. Output has sales on these all the time, so I'll put that in there. All right, so let's get into this instrumental. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is play these chords. And the preset I'm using is the Chordissimo. I believe that's how you say it. All right, so let's hear what these chords sound like. All right, so now let's hear it with the effects that I added onto it. I used the Good Hertz plugin to do some filtering, and then I used the Movement just to add a little bit of ambience to it. All right, so let's move to the next one. The next one I'm using As Android Sleeps, and this is a lead that is in the DX7. So let's hear what that sounds like without any of the effects. All right, and let's hear it with the effects on. I'm gonna just add the other chords in too. Let's put the drums with it. All right, so as you can hear, it's coming along, it's moving along. Now, basically, those are the same chords, just played with a different instrument. The bass are the same chords as well, just with a different instrument. All right, so for the bass, I didn't put any effects. I'm using the Saw Bass that is one of the DX7 presets. So let's hear that by itself, and then we'll add the other elements in. All right, so next we have the classic e-piano from the DX7, and I'm using the mode wheel just to give it a little bit of different texture. So I want to show you that right quick. So let me play it by itself, and I'll turn movement off, and let's hear that. All right. And now let's hear that with movement. All right, and now let's play what we got so far all together. Moving right along. Now, next up, we have the Hyperion Strings, which is from Sound Iron. This is really great for giving you that live element when you're making instrumentals, because sometimes you lack that when you use a lot of MIDI instruments. All right. So this gives you that sort of, you know, real life instrument feel. All right. So let me turn the effect off on that. And this is what we got for this part. All right, now let's hear it with the effect on it. All right, and let's hear everything together now. All right, and for the last one, I am using the Hyperion strings again, just to add another string element. So let's hear what that sounds like by itself, and then we'll add the effect on it, and then we'll play it in the mix with everything. All right, and now let's go. All right, and now let's hear everything together. So that's all I have for you today. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel. If you want to see more of these videos, let me know. I am Marcus with Machine City Audio. Peace, and until next time.